told you guys I'd make a video. I did the Dr. Joe Dispenza, like, online. I did the Dr. Joe Dispenza online course. And it's been a few weeks now since I finished it, but I'm still practicing the meditations. And it's really hard to decipher what's come up for me. I'll tell you one thing that's been made very obvious is that I'm very undisciplined when it comes to meditation. And something that's really echoed a lot when it comes to how well this meditation is going to impact your life is how much of a disciplined person are you when it comes to doing the work. And keep in mind, these meditations are typically 40 plus minutes long, and the expectation is for you to be doing them daily regardless of anything else. I found that incredibly difficult. With the online progressive workshop, it has sort of video sermons or classes, and they're about an hour or so long. They are so good, they're so informative. It's so helpful for people that may have no background in meditation, or people like myself. I've done several hundred meditations over the course of the last, let's say, I've been meditating for maybe 4 or 5 years, so I'm still pretty amateur at the game, but I am at a stage now where I'm quite comfortable doing a 40-minute meditation. Even saying that, it's still difficult for me to do that every single day. Even saying that, I know how beneficial they are to me. And for myself, having a very active, anxious mind, the benefits I get from doing a 40-minute meditation is unlike anything else. All the things people want to talk about when it comes to Joe Dispenza workshops is there's sort of a mystical experience, or sort of a cosmic intervention. A lot of people, if you look on his YouTube or go to his workshops, they talk about healings, like miraculous healings, people healing from cancers, broken bones, financial problems, you name it, relationship issues. They've got these like incredible stories, and testimonies is what they're called, of how they've come to achieving these things or getting these things, manifesting them. I don't know how I feel about that word, in life, as a result of them doing these meditations. Some people are at a place where they can manifest things quite rapidly, and sometimes it takes people a couple years. And to be in a place where you have the mindset, where you're going to have the discipline of putting forth the energy towards something without having expectation of it coming to fruition is difficult for me. I'm a very black and white thinker, and so for me to be at a place of investing a lot of my time and not seeing any result to resolve is very challenging. For me, I think the biggest motive for me to be doing this course is I want to have more peace. I want to have a less active mind. I want to have less panic in my life, and I want to be at a place of more clarity and less of that obnoxious fear that always bombards my head. And I think what else has been revealed to me is that there's a lot of emotional blockage there for me that I just wasn't aware of before. You know, what I found through maybe the end of the course is we're going through meditations called New Potentials, or Blessing the Energy Centers, which she calls centers, but they are chakras, is I had like these emotional releases where I was just bawling, like my face was just soaked. It was like this release that I never expected. And, you know, to this day, I think as I go into these meditations, this part of me that kind of wants that to have that experience again, because it just felt so amazing. That would be probably the biggest extent to something that came up for me that's unexpected. I'm tapping into the divine, or God as I call it. And you know, I do have certain anticipation of having more. There's a greedy side of me that wants to have reward for this meditation work. But I really have no idea what's going to come about, you know. For me, this really ties in hand to hand with my recovery work. You know, tomorrow actually I'll be 9 years sober. And part of my solution is, of course, you know, I'm Christian, of course, but I also partake in an anonymous program that utilizes the 12 steps, which has been amazing. And if you know, in step 11, it talks about it's all through prayer and meditation to improve your conscious contact with God. And so for me, I feel that like it'd be pretty difficult for me to go back to be living without this meditation aspect of my life, just because I just feel so much more clear in the head. Will I be at a place where I have these, you know, incredible manifestations or testimony? I have no idea. Would I love to be one of those people? I would love that. But it's one of these things I have to learn to continually surrender to and just put the work in. So you're struggling with meditation. I was one of those people too who couldn't even sit still for 2 minutes, right? So I recommend what you might want to do is get like the Insight Timer app, which is amazing. There's the Calm app, which is amazing too. And something a few years ago that I paid for was the Headspace. And it was really, really straightforward. And what I found is that, you know, it's like anything you do in life, you get what you pay for. It's my experience. And it really sort of grabs your hand and helps you sort of go through the process of what it's like to be able to sit even for 2 minutes, and you get up to 10 minutes, and you get to 20 minutes, you're like, oh my God, this is fucking amazing. And now today, like, I have my sights on maybe like an hour long meditation, right? You know, something, the progressive workshop when I did it online, you know, setting yourself up in a really calm, quiet environment is really important. For me, I found it more effective not to do like a walking meditation or a seated meditation. I found it best, like I lie right down on the floor here. I put my good old headset on, like these Bose noise canceling headphones. I plugged into meditation and I went for it. And I found that to be most effective for me. I do have some neck injuries and some shoulder injuries that would sort of grab my attention. So it was one way to sort of shut that off, make me less distracted. And but I wonder, you know, as a collective vibe, if you would be at a place where you got more value for your money if you did these workshops in person. I went to a science and spirituality conference a couple years ago where I was first sort of face-to-face introduced to Joe's work. We did a group meditation as I've written about before, and it was amazing. Like, it was really touching, and you just felt like you were part of something and connected to something way bigger than yourself, and it felt much different than the other meditations I've experienced previously. And so for me, not to be at a place of feeling like suckered into this, you know, because if you want to do the further class, which is the advanced seminar, it's probably like, I don't know, $1,800, $2,000 US, which is not cheap. Plus your flight, right? Like, it can be a very expensive expenditure. But, you know, I kind of look at it this way. Like, what does it cost for me to go see a counselor? You know, it's probably like anywhere from $100 to $200, right? And how frequently do I have to do that? Well, it depends on where I'm at in life. When it comes to meditation, I feel that it not only helps me deal with emotional things, it gives my central nervous system a rest, which is like a huge benefit for me, someone who carries a lot of tension in my body. And yeah, I just can't imagine not meditating going forward, right? A sponsor of mine years ago, he used to say it's hard to go back to living a lie once you have a taste of the truth. And I feel that meditation is a truth in my life that I don't want to run away from. So there's sort of a short taste of my Joe Dispenza progressive workshop experience. And feel free to leave a comment below or email me at kale@growthguided.com, K-A-E-L. And I'd be happy to connect you with a little bit more depth of my experience. It's hard to sort of let everything out in a short video because it was a really emotional experience for me, I found. So, anyways, I thank you guys for listening. Don't forget to press the like button and subscribe.